G'day guys, this time around I thought we'd check out the 135 scale new Centurion by Warriors, sculpted by Trevor Hensley. First of all, one of the nice things that comes with this figure is the actual background, would you believe it, of the actual whatever he's exiting or entering. And I'll just put my little Tamir figure there again, just to give you the scale of it. And I've painted this actually because I've actually used it in for a backdrop of one of my Warhammer figures. It's also got a little tread on the ramp there. So as you can see here, as usual, Warriors have done another great job on casting this figure. And Trevor's done a fantastic job in sculpting it. The more and more I pull out some of my figures, the more I realise that I've got quite a few of Trevor Hensley's sculpted figures. And I just absolutely love this one. I kind of wish he'd done a whole group of these figures. I've got him leaning back a little bit on the base just because he's crouching over, just to try and show you his stomach a little bit easier so he's not folded over. But all the little pockets in his trousers and his ammo packs, really nicely done. You get a lot of pouches, added on pouches for him, and a nice rifle. And another thing you also get back then is you also got two heads. One with his helmet on and one without. And the heads are done very well. As I said, you get two heads. And when I pulled this one out, the face on it, I thought I was looking at a hornet head. Just the sculpting of his facial features, I've got a fair few hornet heads, and when I pulled it out, it just reminded me of one of those. It's a great face sculpt. I'll just zoom in on his rifle and his pistol as they're nicely detailed. As you can see, you get enough ammo pouches and other bags and his water bottle. Maybe a little bit old, that water bottle. Looks a little bit World War II to me. But his rifle and his pistol are well done. It's a pretty cool rifle. And again, I like how they've sculpted the hands onto the gun, which makes it look a lot more realistic and will make the lining up of the arms easier. And his pistol here reminded me of Star Wars for some reason. Is it Luke Skywalker's or Han Solo's pistol? Kind of reminded me of that. But again, it's for 135 scale and the size of it. It's very well done. And again, you've sort of got the locking little pins and tabs on the sides of the arm to connect it up nicely. It's a cracker of a 135 scale figure. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I'll catch you later.